Welcome to Great Hymns of the Faith. My name is John Fraser. I'm your host. And as always, it's great to have you with us today, folks. Do you know, today is the last Sunday in November. Whoa! December is right ahead of us. And next Sunday is the first Sunday in Advent. Wow, where does time go? I don't know. But some days it seems to go faster than other days, doesn't it? Well, let me tell you just a little bit about our first hymn. We're going to begin our program today with a hymn of praise. The words to the hymn, "When Morning Gilds the Skies," have come out of Germany, and so they needed to be translated into English. And they were translated from German to English by Edward Caswell, and later as well by Robert S. Bridges. I trust that you'll enjoy this hymn of praise, "When Morning Gilds the Skies." Let me tell you just a little bit about a hymn that is loved by many, and it's right up there at the top of the list of people's favorites. The author, in 1885, at the age of 26, a Swedish preacher by the name of Carl G. Boberg wrote the words of a poem entitled "O Stor Gud." Several years later, Boberg attended a meeting and was surprised to hear his poem being sung to an old Swedish melody. What is the name of a hymn that started out as a poem? Let me play it for you.
I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, I'm not who I ought to be, your name is
Coates was born on April 6, 1901 in Summerland, Mississippi. He attended the schools of his area, and he was a student and a lover of music all of his life. His formal education was continued with study at Mississippi Southern College and Louisiana State University. He also studied music intensely. When just a lad of about 14, he began teaching music classes and conducting evangelistic singing. He was a teacher in public schools most of his life, and he was the composer of many loved gospel pieces. And amongst them is the gospel song, "Where Could I Go But to the Lord?"
Chilling hand of death, where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? Oh, where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul.
Hatch, 1835 to 1889. Hatch attended Cambridge and Pembroke College, Oxford. He was ordained an Anglican priest in 1859. He immigrated to Canada, where he became a professor of classics at Trinity College. He later became rector of a high school in Quebec. But in 1867, he returned to England. Hatch is known as the author of the hymn, "Breathe on Me, Breath of God."
That I may love what
Well, coming up now is another classic hymn of none other than Fanny Crosby and the man responsible for the music, Robert Lowry. Enjoy All the Way, My Savior Leads Me.
All the way, my Savior leads me. What have I to ask beside? Can I doubt His tender mercy, who through life has been my guide? Heavenly peace, divinest comfort, here by faith in Him to dwell. For I know whate'er befall me, Jesus doeth all things well. For I know whate'er befall me, Jesus doeth all things well.
All the way my Savior leads me, choose each winding path I tread. Gives me grace for every trial, feeds me with the living bread. Though my weary steps may falter, and my soul athirst may be, gushing from the rock before me, though a stream of joy I see. Gushing from the rock before me, my song through endless ages, Jesus led me all the way. This my song through endless ages, Jesus led me all the way.
Samuel Trevor Francis, 1834 to 1925. He was the son of a London merchant and artist. Francis belonged to the Plymouth Brethren congregation in London and served as an open-air preacher. He published a number of hymns, and one of his hymns that I'm going to share with you now is called Oh, the Deep, Deep Love of Jesus.
How He loveth everlasting.
The author of the well-known hymn, "Oh, for a Thousand Tongues to Sing," was none other than Charles Wesley, 1707 to 1788. It is said that Wesley wrote this hymn to commemorate the first anniversary of his conversion to Christ.
Oh,
There is an interesting bit of history behind the hymn, Come, Thou Almighty King. This hymn is credited to Charles Wesley, but on very slight evidence that he is the author. While it has been one of the most popular and widely used hymns among American Methodists, English Methodists, strangely enough, have never given it a place in any of their official hymnals. It was written to be sung to the familiar tune to which God Save the King and My Country, 'Tis of Thee are sung. However, it was sung again by many who viewed it and recognized it at one time as the national hymn of England. Come, Thou Almighty King. I am glad that you're able to join us today, folks, and I trust, as always, that you enjoyed the hymns that I was able to share with you, and I hope that, be good Lord willing, that you will be able to join us next week as well for yet more of great hymns of the faith. Until then, God bless.